Black holes are a deep, dark mystery, literally. Our galaxy alone is thought to contain anywhere between 10 million to a billion of them. We know that they have the ability to destroy planets, maybe even solar systems, but why exactly? What is going on in there? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that wants to answer everything and anything, because actually, curiosity didn't kill the cat. That's just a thing people say to keep you in your place. Knowledge is power, but is there anything more powerful than a black hole? Seamless. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what is inside of a black hole? Okay, but also I really quickly want to say that each and every time I host these videos, Muse's supermassive black hole dances through my head all day. Anyone else know that song? Or is it just me? Right, before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys what you think is inside of a black hole. While you're down there leaving a comment, why don't you hit that thumbs up button and share this video with a person that needs to see the inside of a black hole today. Take that as you will. Also, if you want to connect with the team that went into making this video, there are links to our socials in the description box. Alright, black holes. Black holes were first discussed in the 18th century, but it was David Finkelstein's 1958 publication that established them as a region of space from which nothing can escape. Fast forward 60 years and we now know a little more about black holes, but, excuse the very intentional pun, we are still very much in the dark. In fact, one of the biggest goals in astrophysics is to understand and observe what happens in a black hole. What we do know is that black holes are areas of space and time that exhibit such strong gravitational pulls on things, from particles to radiation and even light, that nothing can escape it. This has led scientists to realize that black holes are very, very, very dense. There are two types of observable black holes, supermassive and stellar mass, although there may well be a third, miniature black holes. Welcome to the party, tiny friends. At the moment, we're going to talk about the two observables. Supermassive black holes have the mass of many millions, maybe even billions of stars, and stellar mass black holes are still dense, but on a much smaller scale. These black holes come from the gravitational collapse of a huge star. Our sun, though, would need to be around 25 times its size to create a supernova and then a black hole. It's just not gonna happen. Stellar mass black holes can be anywhere from 10 times the density of our sun. The nearest one to Earth is thought to be up to 12 times the mass of our sun. Now this is named Monocerotis. It's 3,000 light years away, so that's 18 trillion miles. No worries. It would take the fastest rocket we have on Earth hundreds of thousands of years to reach it, so probing is basically at this point not an option. We are doing our best when it comes to telescopes, however. Hubble can actually observe light from 13.2 billion light years away, and we're even creating special telescopes to be able to look at these black holes. We can see them, we just can't travel to get a better look. So, as you may have gathered, because of the limitations of current technology, we can only observe what is going on surrounding a black hole rather than knowing what exactly is inside. However, our observations have given us a few clues. It seems that black holes are so dense, infinitely dense, that they cause the laws of physics as we know them to break down completely. The way gravity works is that objects of a lower mass are drawn towards objects of a higher mass. Black holes, once again, have an extremely high mass, and they start to break down things that approach them. It can tear planets apart, even stars apart, maybe even galaxies. The black hole is kind of a drain in slow motion. Particles that have been torn from what they previously are, as well as radiation and light, swirl in that hole until they eventually fall in. This swirl is called the event horizon, which is very much the point of no return. From this point, you can't see any light, as no light can escape. We have never seen beyond the event horizon. All we see is what's not there. Darkness, a black hole. We do, again, have some pretty educated theories as to what could be inside, though. For starters, it is expected to be super hot. The event horizon may as well be called the ring of fire. As material gets consumed by the black hole, friction heats up to billions of degrees, producing lots of radiation and outflows of energy and charged particles. If we were to pass beyond the event horizon, we'd be incinerated. Beyond that, it is thought that the black hole is like a funnel, leading down to a small, extremely infinitely dense place, just one atom wide, as matter is destroyed and sucked into the hole. This is stretched out in a process scientists like to call spaghettification. The thing is, even if we could get up close to a black hole, anything or anyone we have on Earth would be destroyed and sucked in, so couldn't report back exactly what is inside. It's a paradox. Although, the paradox in theory could be broken if something could travel fast enough through it, perhaps faster than the speed of light. It's just a theory, but some cosmologists are pretty keen on it. Even if we could travel faster, I'm not sure that I would want to be the one doing the testing. Towards the end of his life, Professor Stephen Hawking was working on a theory of multiverses. He alluded to the possibility of a black hole spilling its matter into a separate place, perhaps a new universe. He said the hole would need to be large, and if it was rotating, it might have a passage to another universe, but you couldn't come back to ours. Stephen, what does that mean? So, what is in a black hole? If it sounds like I haven't really answered the question so much as I have discussed black holes in general, you'd be right. As of yet, we simply do not know what's inside a black hole, but we can discuss them and study them. The answer may be closer on the horizon than we think, too. Scientists have created a machine called the Large Hadron Collider. It's a particle smasher that they want to use to simulate some of the things that happened at the beginning of the universe. Not only could this machine shed more light on the Big Bang, some think it could create miniature black holes. This may be a touch far-fetched, but if it could, then perhaps we'd be able to answer this question once and for all. But until then, I don't know. Shrug. So guys, what do you think is in a black hole? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, why don't you click on that thumbs up button and the notification bell to be the first to hear a big answer? Honestly, my head feels like it's been sucked into a black hole, so I need to get out of here. Thank you guys for listening though. The more we ask these questions, the closer we get to answers. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.